jangles and he'll dance for you with worn out shoes, silver hair, a ragged shirt, baggy pants. He would do the old soft shoe. He would jump so high, jump so high, and then he'd lightly touch down. He told me of a time he worked with minstrel shows, just traveling throughout the South. He spoke with tears for 15 years, how his dog and he, well, they just travel about. But his dog up and died. Oh, just got up and died. And after 20 years, he still breathes. He should have danced now and every chance in honky tonks for my drinks and tips. Most of the time, I just spend behind his county barge. You see, son, I drinks a bit. And then he shook his head. Oh, Lord! And when he shook his head, I could swear I heard somebody say, please, please, oh, Mr. Bojangles, I'm calling Mr. Bojangles. Hey, Mr. Bojangles, come back and dance. And dance, and dance, please dance, Mr. Bojangles.
So, Jill, down the front, would you like this? You can have this. This is for you. Is that all right, Jill? I've got your bingo dress on, I noticed. Eyes down, looking. That's nice, OK. Who's that man sitting next? Is that your husband there? Just a friend of the kids? That's your name, OK. What's your name, sir? Glyn. Oh, nice name. OK, Glyn. I've got something for you, Glyn. Something for Glyn. Is that all right? Okay, and Mr. Carhill, would you like that? Or would you prefer one of these? What would you like? Choice is yours, Mr. Carhill. You want that? I'll leave these up here, you can have that. Okay, is that lady with you as well? Yes, she's kind of that, that's mine. But look like that one's yours. Is that all right? Yeah? I'll show you mine, you show me yours. Good, show me. Go on, show it to me, sir. Oh, you dirty bugger, I knew you were dirty. What else? There's a couple of kids, a little boy down there. Oh no, I've got nothing left for the little boy there. That's a bugger, isn't it, mate? I know what to do. Glyn, can I swap? Can I swap? Thank you, Glyn. Here you go, mate. It's not often you get something for nothing round here, is it, mate? That's fine, mate. Well done. Just something a little bit different, a little bit special now, because magicians, you might see magicians in the past, they make animals appear in their acts. Some magicians might make like a rabbit appear from a hat, some might even make like a dove appear from a handkerchief, some might even make a mountain goat appear with some Wellington boots, but that's another show completely. So tonight, before your very eyes, ladies and gentlemen, I'm now going to make appear from behind this cloth, ladies and gentlemen, a fully grown Australian 18-foot man-eating crocodile. You don't give a monkeys, do you, eh? Very good. Speaking of monkeys, there's two monkeys in the bath, and one went, woo, 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 and the other one said, put some cold water in then. 18-foot Australian man-eating crocodile. Now, I have to say, ladies and gentlemen, there can only be one survivor on this, okay? It'll either be me or him. I eat him or he eats me. Okay. One. I also want to say, ladies and gentlemen, you've been a fantastic audience tonight. You've been lovely. Thank you very much for being so nice. And I think, right, if you really work at it, you could go all the way. I do. You could end up at the London Palladium, all right? But don't do what a lot of audiences do, which is they just as they go out the door, they split up and never see each other again. That's a real shame, all right? You deserve better than that. Okay. Okay, listen. But I love you too. I understand. It's me mum. Okay. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. On the contrary, also, ladies and gentlemen, this is a... I want to say, down the Sea Life Centre, I found out valuable information. Apparently, a shark will only attack you when you're wet, which is something worth bearing in mind. If you ever go swimming in the... Oh, God! Do you know what I said? I said, sharks will only attack when you're wet. Is a man eater, but he only eats ugly people, okay? So most of us are going to be all right, all right? Glyn, you might want to move back a few rows. Okay, one last thing. I meant to say this a little while ago. I've said a lot of things tonight that I didn't mean in jest, ladies and gentlemen. It was just a joke. A lot of stuff I really didn't mean, okay? But just now, Glyn, I said that I implied that you was ugly, all right? I didn't mean it, all right? And Mr. Carhill, right, I said earlier, I pointed that, I said you was a slaphead, didn't I? And I didn't mean that, okay? And the lady over there, I just spat some water out, I didn't mean that. Okay, and Jill, down the front there, I said you was a foxy lady. I didn't mean that. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming. 18-foot crocodile. Start the music now. 1, 2, 3, go.
Mr. Joker Squally.